Hey everyone, Amelia Roberts here, and today we are talking about integrating Power Automate into Copilot Studio. Copilot Studio is a Microsoft tool in which you can create custom copilots or chatbots for your organization or your company. There are various ways to customize this process and these copilots, and one of those ways is by integrating Power Automate into your chat flow to kind of efficiently enhance and automate things that are happening within your organization. Let's head on over to Copilot Studio and integrate some Power Automate into one of our chat flows. So here I am in Copilot Studio, and what I'm going to do is I am already in a pre-created Copilot that I have made in advance. And what I'm going to do is I am going to go to my topics, and I'm going to choose a topic to integrate Power Automate into. I'm going to choose my thank you topic. This is one of the topics that's already typically involved in all copilots that are created. And what I want to do here in this topic is when somebody says thanks or thank you, I want to say you're welcome. And then I would like it to ask for their email address. And then after they provide their email address, I would like it to send them not only a confirmation within my copilot saying thank you for your email address, but I also wanted to send them an email immediately saying you have been subscribed to our email list, whatever it may be. So I'm going to add a few parts to this. Our Power Automate connection is going to be connected to a variable within our Copilot flow. So I'm going to go ahead and add a node here, and I'm going to have it ask a question because I want it to ask for their email address. So I'm just going to say, would you like to join our email subscription? And then going to kind of create what I want from them. So I'm going to choose my identify as email. There are a lot of great options in here, by the way. As an email right here, extracted as a string. And then that is going to create my email variable. I'm going to change the name of this variable from var1 to varemail because I like to be a little bit more descriptive. You'll probably make a lot of variables when you're creating your copilot, so just being specific is really helpful along the process. I'm going to call my varemail. I'm also going to make it global so that I can use it within other topics if I would like to. If I left it topic, then I could only use it within this topic. I may want to use it somewhere else along the way. So I'm just going to go ahead and put it as global just in case. That is a preference. You do not have to do that. So now I'm saying, you're welcome. Would you like to join our email? Asking for their email. Now, when they respond with their email address, this is when I would like to kick off a Power Automate flow. To do this, I need to use an action. So I'm going to add a node and I'm going to call an action. So when I do that, I'm going to choose create a flow, which is going to launch Power Automate, or as it says here, Microsoft Flow. So it is going to launch Power Automate for me. And what I'm going to do here is it already has a template. So I just need to adjust this template accordingly. I'm going to choose run a flow from Copilot. This is where I'm going to put my input. My input is my email. So I'm going to choose text and I'm going to call it email. This input is what I'm going to tie to my variable once I get back into Copilot Studio. So I have the email input. Now I need to add the email that is going to be sent out as a confirmation. So I'm going to choose add an action. And then I'm going to go up here, I'm going to type an email. And I'm just going to connect mine to my Outlook here because that's just what's easiest right now, especially because I would like you to see when the email comes in. And so I have send an email. I'm going to choose that. Just so you know, too, if you choose this, there is going to be a permission section that will come up. I will actually show you that when we test our copilot. But I'm going to, for the two, I need to enter a specific custom value because this is where my variable is going to be. This is where whatever email address they put in our copilot, I want it to put it here in my two. So I'm going to choose a custom, and then I'm going to go to get data from the previous step, and I'm going to choose my input, the email, because that input, remember, is tied to our email variable back in Copilot Studio. I'm going to put a subject and a body. So thank you for subscribing. And in the body, you are now subscribed. Just something simple for now to give us an idea of what this looks like. So that's all I want to really put in the email. I'm happy with that. There are a ton of other options here, by the way, that you can check out. I'm not going to mess with any of those right now because we're just doing a very basic understanding of this. And then what I need to do is my output. So what's going to happen in the Copilot after somebody provides their email? So I'm going to add an output text. I'm going to just call this confirm. And this is where I want to say your email address, so-and-so, has been subscribed. That's what's going to go back through the chatbot. So not only are they going to get an email that says, hey, you've been subscribed, but they're also going to get a message in the Copilot that says, hey, you've been subscribed. So I want to say your email, comma, and now I want to refer to their email address. So I'm going to use that input again, has been subscribed. And that's all I want to put. Nice and simple. So I have my input, I have the email that's being sent out, and I have my output. I am going to rename this really quick. Just let's call it YouTube Jax Flow, because our Copilot that I'm using is called Jax. And then I'm going to save this. All right, my flow is ready to go. We recommend you test it. So you can test it here if you want to. You can hit this and do test manually, or even after, if you have issues, you can choose automatically, and then it will give you the previous flows that you've tried. But let's go back into our Copilot Studio, finish this off so that it can really run the way we want. All right, so now I need to call that action, and we are going to see our YouTube Jax flow show up here. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. Now I need to tie my variables to my input and my output. So my input is the email, so I need to tie the variable to my email variable. And then I have this confirm string here. I do need to add another message and put this variable in here so that the flow completes. So I'm just going to send a message in the chat, and I'm going to put my confirm variable here. And then that is going to be the end of my conversation in this section. So you can even put like end conversation, or you can have it start from the beginning, whatever it is you would like to do. Here, I'm not going to do that. It is completely up to you. But here is our complete flow. They're going to say, thank you. You're welcome. Would you like to join our email list? Provides email. And then they are going to get an email that says they've confirmed. And the Copilot is going to say, your email has been confirmed. So let's save this. And then we're going to test it by using our test Copilot over here on the right-hand side. So right now it's saying, what is your name? I'm going to say Amelia. And then I'm going to put in my trigger phrase so that I can launch the topic that I have here. I'm going to put thanks. All right. Would you like to join our email subscription? Provide an email. I'm going to do my Pragmatic Works email so that maybe we can see this in real time happening. Hopefully it goes all the way through, but just know this is the part where you're going to maybe have to do some permissions. If you use Outlook, it will say, yes, review all permissions. I'm going to go ahead and fix this now. Review all permissions. I just have to say like, it's okay if you use this. I'm going to use my YouTube Jax flow here. I'm going to go actually to the settings here, and I'm just going to give it permission. I just have to say submit, and then it will connect officially here. So now it's connected. Let's go back and just try this again really quick now that we are all good to go. So I am actually going to refresh. Hi, what's your name? Amelia. Thanks. A Roberts at pragmaticworks.com. And now that I've given it permission, it should launch and work. Your email, aroberts@pragmaticworks.com, has been subscribed. So we did complete this entire flow. It did go all the way to the end. And then if I were to check my email, actually right now, I was hoping it would pop up here, then we would be able to see your email has been subscribed. So let me actually see if I can find my email really quick, and then we can bring this up. And yep, I have an email right here that says you have been subscribed. So we have officially completed this copilot. It looks great. I hope this demonstration was helpful, and I will see you in the next video.